Suddenly, I found myself in Jammu and Kashmir in the midst of turmoil, uncertainty, and chaos, where life seemed to be going on reverse gear. After long years spent in Delhi, it was a big jolt to my life. Maybe a new beginning. What was in store for me? I often sought an answer from the universe. This is going to be a period of hibernation. A high-profile me decided to have a no-profile for the time being. It was time to introspect, search the purpose, the mission of my very existence on this planet. Gradually, I started to understand this state, its people, their art and culture, and more precisely, its spirit. The tranquil beauty of the place took my breath away. It seeped inside me. Nature, in its bounty, had a healing effect on me. It enriched me, and I found solace in my own company. This was the beginning of my connection with myself. I started a walk within, found a road to reach my own being. While traveling inside, I also found that traveling outside was also a part of knowing my own self. Photography and video making engulfed me with such intense passion that I thought of making a documentary film on Kashmir. The poets of the valley, especially Habba Khatun and Lal Dey, have always been a great source of inspiration. The Sufi philosophy is very close to my heart, and I am a firm believer of Shiv and Shakti. I do not consider myself a mere tourist or an outsider. My strong conviction and belief is that I belong to this land of mystic. While engaging myself with the mysteries of nature, I have tried to understand my own self. The creative spirit does not accept barriers of caste, creed, gender, color, and religion. It is limitless, infinite. The king and their kingdoms, or the battles fought by them, do not make history of India. It is the wisdom of its saints, poets, and philosophers who, through their knowledge and teachings, have laid the foundation of this nation. Kashmir also has produced such saints, philosophers, and poets who have not only enriched the country, but the world at large. Amidst turmoil and trouble, the saving grace is the legacy of its saint poets like Lal Dey, Roop Bhavani, Abhinav Gupta, whose creative spirit has transcended space and time. They belong to the universe and have shown the divine light to one and all who have gone through their teachings. Lal Dey, through her work, has emphasized over and over again that if one knows thyself, one knows the God. In ancient northern India, along with Banaras, Kashmir was the seat of learning. After gaining knowledge in Banaras, scholars went to Kashmir for higher studies, particularly to Sharda Peeth. Prativigyan Darshan, the doctrine of recognition, is the knowledge of discovering the self which connects one with the divine. Kashmir Shaivism finds its inception in the 8th century sage Vasu Gupta, to whom Shiv Sutras were revealed. His descendants Somanand, Utpal Dev, and Abhinav Gupta gave a concrete foundation to their philosophy, which lays emphasis on the relationship between God, nature, and man, and leads one to the path of self-realization and celebration of life. This philosophy has invoked deep interest in the West and has led to intensive research in various universities there. The focal point of Kashmir Shaivism is the ultimate reality, Param Shiv, the source of everything and into which merges everything. Param Shiv is beyond description, beyond manifestation, beyond form, time and space. Param Shiv is eternal, infinite, all-pervading, all-knowing. In this search, one discovers thyself and then connects to the ultimate universal being through faith and awareness. To understand cosmic evolution, Shaivism postulates 36 categories of tattvas, which reveal the elements of the nature, Panch Mahabhutas, earth, water, fire, air, and ether. The external manifestation of the divine creative energy is called the Shiv Tattva, and the kinetic cosmic energy that affects the divine consciousness is Shakti Tattva. Kashmir, once the beacon of tolerance and inclusiveness, underwent a phase of hate and intolerance. And yet, because of its great survival instinct, continues to remain the pristine crown of India. Even when traveling was extremely difficult, Islam spread through Sufi travelers who were ardent followers of ascetic discipline. These Sufis produced enormous wealth of literature to express the state of consciousness which guided the travelers of the spiritual path, who were drawn to Islam and Kashmir, the seat of Sufism, a unique devotional culture synonymous with spiritual quest, peace and harmony. This phenomena is weaved into the psyche and spiritual fabric of the people of this land. In the entire subcontinent, Kashmir has the richest tradition of Sufism. It is the integral part of the life of its people. In 1990s, Kashmir unfortunately was trapped in militancy and peace-loving people of Kashmir took to violence, which lasted for a decade and a half. The cultural traditions are not static. They are firmly resilient. In adversity, they may lose sight of their values, but they are never lost permanently. The insurgency did affect the collective psyche and consciousness of the people. After a while, they did regain their values and Sufi traditions of peace and love. Gar Firdaus Bar Rue Zami Ast Hameen Asto Hameen Asto Hameen Ast. If there is a paradise on earth, it is this, it is this, it is this. Despite the unrest and the violence, Kashmir's sheer beauty continues to give meaning to Amir Khusro's famous words. Kashmir is heaven on earth with its alpine peaks and snow-clad ranges, an unbelievably beautiful landscape, valley of flowers, serene lakes, and amazing trekking trails. Kashmir Valley, the largest Himalayan valley, is an elliptical saucer-shaped landmark of Kashmir. Surrounded by the Karakoram and Pir Panjal ranges, the valley has a mesmerizing view from all directions possible. Though the crown of India, Kashmir has been one of the most sought after, is a quiet, spiritually awake, and yet the surreal beauty of this land is often lost in unfortunate turmoil and strife. Dal is a lake in Srinagar. Dal in Kashmiri means lake. Till recently, Srinagar was the summer capital of Jammu and Kashmir. The urban lake is integral to tourism and recreation in Kashmir and is named as Jewel in the Crown of Kashmir. It is unique because of its Victorian era wooden houseboats, originally built as vacation homes for landless British administrators during the British Raj. Tourists love to stay in these houseboats, which are parked in the lake in huge numbers. The street along this section of the lake is known as the Boulevard Street and makes for a pleasant walk in the evening, just in time for the sun to set into the lake's deep blue mysteries. A shikara ride on the Dal in Srinagar is a must-do activity for any tourist. Shikara is a wooden boat used for the transport of people and goods in the lakes all over Kashmir. The shoreline of the lake is about 15.5 kilometers and has a boulevard line with Mughal Gardens, Shalimar Bagh, and Nishat Bagh, built during the reign of Mughal Emperor Jahangir. And from houseboats cruising along the lake in the bright colored shikaras. During the winters, the temperature sometimes reaches minus 11 degree centigrade, freezing the lake. The lake covers an area of 18 square kilometers and is part of the natural wetland, which covers about 21 square kilometers, including its floating gardens and lotus flowers during July and August. The wetland is divided by causeways into four basins: Gagribal, Lokut Dal, Bod Dal, and Nagin. Lokut Dal and Bod Dal each have an island in the center. One of them is the famous Char Chinar. The lake is also an important source for commercial operations in fishing and water plant harvesting. Dal Lake is brimming with vendors selling vegetables and other fresh produce in the morning. Spectacular sunrises over the mountains makes it worth the pain of rising early, even in extremely cold weather. Floating gardens, called Darad in Kashmiri, are a special feature of the lake. They consist matted vegetation and earth, but are floating. These are detached from the bottom of the lake and drawn to a suitable place and anchored. Given its rich nutrient properties, tomatoes, cucumbers, and melons are grown there. The fishing industry on Dal is the second largest industry in the region and is central to many of the people's livelihoods who reside on the lake's periphery. Fishermen use a locally manufactured cast net, which comprises six parts with a diameter of 6 meters. It is operated from a wooden fishing boat made out of devdar. Pari Mahal, this beautiful garden is also famous as the Palace of Fairies, and rightly so. From a distance, it looks inviting and mystical in equal measures. It is a seven-terraced garden and dates back to the 1600s. It sits above the very famous and stunning Chashmeshahi Garden. Tulip Garden, a photographer's paradise. This is the largest tulip garden in Asia. It is spread over a massive 30 hectares and sits at the bottom of the Zabarwan Range. Think of Srinagar and you cannot skip a trip to this place. However, this garden is open to public only for a month. Mostly the tulips bloom from 1st April till the end of the month. The life of this blooming period is about a month. This is the advent of spring in Kashmir. Jama Masjid. Jama Masjid, a mosque in Srinagar, Kashmir, is situated at Nowhatta in the middle of the old city, which was commissioned by Sultan Sikandar in 1394 CE and completed in 1402 CE. The mosque is located in downtown Srinagar.
Sultan Sikandar Shah, Kashmir, Shahmiri, in 1394 AD. Father of Sultan Zainul Abidin is the famous name of a king in Kashmir. Measurement is 381 feet into 384 feet. Built-in area of this masjid is 1,46,000 square feet. That means 27 canals of land. Width of brick wall 5 feet and 4 feet. Jami Masjid, it is unique architecture, was majestic. 378 wooden deodar pillars That is worth seeing, ma'am. This is the only masjid in the country where we have 3, 7, 8 wooden didar pillars supporting wooden ceiling with 3, 4, 6 pillars of 21 feet high and 5 feet girth, and 32 pillars of 48 feet high and 60 feet girth. The masjid is provided with a fountain measuring 33 feet into 34 feet, which also serves purpose of ablution. Ablution means wudu. Jama Masjid can hold 3,33,033 people. This is wonderful, ma'am. 3,33,334 people for Salah means namaz. Pulpit mihrab has been decorated with precious granite and engraved with 99 attributes of Almighty Allah. 99 attributes of Almighty. In Islam, God has 99 names. Muslims say offering Friday Salah in Jama Masjid is recompensed with reward 500 times more than offering Salah.
Jama Masjid
Nagin Lake is located adjacent to the Hari Parvat hillock to the west of the Dal Lake. To its north and west, the localities of Bhagwanpura and Lal Bazar, while to its north east lies the locality of Hazrat Bal, which is known for the famous shrine. Hari Parvat. Hari Parvat is a hill overlooking Srinagar, the largest city and summer capital of Jammu and Kashmir till recently. It is the site of a fort built in the Durrani era and of a Hindu temple, mosque and gurudwara. Another name for the hill is Pradyumn Peeth. It is considered sacred by the Kashmiri Pandits and hosts a temple of Shakti, who is worshipped there under the name Jagdamba Sharika Bhagwati, depicted as having 18 arms and sitting in Sri Chakra. The very majestic Hazrat Bal Dargah. This stunning place of worship sits on the left bank of Dal and calls for a visit. It is also the only mosque in Srinagar which has a dome and looks all the more majestic with the high Himalayas looking over it. Naseem Bagh. Naseem Bagh is a Mughal garden built on the northwestern side of the Dal Lake, close to Srinagar in Kashmir. The garden is one of the oldest Mughal gardens in Kashmir, built by Mughal Emperor Akbar in 1586. Over 1200 chinar trees were planted in 1686 by Shah Jahan. It is a Chinar Heritage Park near the University of Kashmir. It is mostly visited by tourists in autumn.